Hey folks, welcome back. Hey, Rex and I are going to do an old southern rock classic for y'all today. It's a 1973 release of one of our favorite southern bands, Lynyrd Skynyrd, and I'm sure it's one of y'all's favorite southern bands. They had many hits, but this was one that kind of resonated with folks all over the world here, this Freebird. There's only one surviving member left. He's the drummer. His name is Artemus Pyle. He actually wasn't with them when they first started, but he started with them, I think, 3 or 4 years later and was with them through all their hits and all their albums. He's 74 years old now, living in Louisville, Kentucky. But, and you know, this is something I didn't know, Rex, but I just did the research on this, you know, not long ago. They actually, and I don't think you knew this, started as far back, you know, we got into them in the late 70s, early 80s and everything, when they were really in their heyday, but they actually started the band in 1964, and the band's name was actually My Backyard.
See, I didn't know that. I didn't know that until you mentioned just a few minutes
ago. Yeah, I didn't either, until I looked it up about 2 or 3 hours ago. Yeah, so they started in 1964. I don't know what year they went and changed the name to Lynyrd Skynyrd, but I'm assuming it was probably the way it looked like on the Wikipedia, and they maybe 4 or 5 years after that, late 60s.
Did they ever give a reason why they changed the name?
I don't see it on the Wikipedia, what I researched, why, no. Now, I might have overlooked it because there's a lot. They're a big, well-known band, so they've got a lot of stuff on them, you know.
Now, you know who Lynyrd Skynyrd was, don't you?
What's that?
He was a chemistry teacher in high school that they had.
Oh, I think I've heard that before.
He sure was.
And that's how they got that name.
Yeah, of course. He didn't spell it like they did. He spelled it L-E-O-N-A-R-D.
They put their own slant to it. Yeah. Well, anyway, we're really looking forward to doing this song. It's one of their biggest hits they ever had. Like I say, it's Freebird, 1973. But I want to say one other thing. Unfortunately, we lost three of them and two backup singers in that horrific plane crash. They were on their way to, I think, down in Louisiana. They crashed in Mississippi in the fall of 1977. I remember I just got out of high school in 77, a little bit before your time there, buddy. And unfortunately, they lost the lead singer, Ronnie Van Zant, in that plane crash, as well as they lost Steve Gaines and Steve Gaines' sister. I don't know if you knew this. They added Steve Gaines, the guitarist, in 1976, so he'd only been playing with him a year and a half before he got killed. He was a great guitarist, too. They added him later, and his sister was a... You remember the backup singers they had in some of their songs? I don't know if you remember the vocals.
Vaguely, yeah.
So we lost them then, and then later after that, their great Alan Collins, he survived the crash, as well as Billy Powell, and Gary Rossington, the great guitarist. And then, unfortunately, Alan Collins died of a pretty premature death in 1990. He had had some, I think he got kind of half paralyzed and everything. He was a great guitarist for him, too. And then, of course, they lost Billy Powell, which was a great keyboardist for them in 2009. And this past March, the great Gary Rossington, the great guitarist for them, he just passed away a few months ago. So they're all gone now, except the Artemus Pyle, their drummer. He's 74 years old in Louisville, Kentucky. Let's do this song here, though. Everybody remembers this. It's called Freebird, a 1973, just awesome, awesome hit. Freebird by Lynyrd Skynyrd. If I leave here tomorrow, would you still remember me? I must be traveling on now. There are too many places I've got to see. If I stay here with you, girl, things just couldn't be the same. 'Cause I'm as free as a bird now, and this bird you cannot change. Oh, and this part you